You're an organisation whose values and commitments translate into the behaviours, attitudes and approaches of the people that work for you.
In the Emerge community, it's just a time to just relax and just have fun and be myself.
I think Emerge has helped me to make more friends from different communities.
If I could describe Emerge in three words, it'd be amazing, encouraging and very helpful.
Emerge started about 15 years ago in this area of BD4. In terms of the issues that the young people face in this area, they face issues around poverty, around criminal activity, lack of aspiration into employment, all those kind of things, all the things that you get from an area of deprivation. We work in schools doing behavioural and therapeutic intervention. We have a dedicated sports team looking at healthy lifestyles with young people in school and in the community. And then finally we do what you typically understand as youth work. So we're delivering youth clubs, youth drop-ins, youth cafes, environment projects and steering groups, really responding to the needs of a community and shaping it based on that community.
We began to think in envisioning the academy how it is we could build a sophisticated approach to working with some of our most vulnerable youngsters. So we had some design from first principle decisions to make, intentionally devising approaches in school which built Emerge into the way we approach meeting some of the needs of our more vulnerable youngsters and beyond, because there's that added value bit.
So Anthony, want to be a captain, you go over there then?
Our vision really is that we engage young people in more than one setting.
You can pick numbers.
That we aim to engage them in their school environment, but also in their community, and begin to create some of that wraparound care that we believe is so essential to a young person in really impacting their lives.
When we began our work more seriously with Emerge, they were coming in to support PE lessons for us. That's developed and improved, and Emerge now plan and run the lessons. The other benefits have been that we have a set of young people in school who are creating positive role models for the children. They show the children how to be conscientious and reliable. They have positive relationships adult to adult, which the children observe, and also positive professional relationships with them. And all of those adults who work with the children nurture them and bring them on with the sorts of value systems that we think are really important.
Emerge take part in our case meetings, which are held weekly in school. And there's a member of staff there represented Emerge. And at those meetings, we discuss individual students and our concerns. Every young person that has been referred to Emerge workers who I've reported back on, of it's been made the impact of the fact that child protection plans are removed, which is always the ideal situation. For me, it shines through even more that it's not just about what happens in the school building or in the youth centres and things like that. It's a care for the community, and the outreach work that goes on, I think, is above and beyond what I've experienced from other organisations.
Last year, when we were celebrating the school's results, a number of those very key individuals that we were most delighted with, their success was very attributable to their relationship with Emerge. And so Emerge's impact can't be underestimated. Your sophisticated approach to the deployment of all that you have with us is securing the participation and engagement of some of our most profoundly vulnerable youngsters with purpose and with benefits. Without you, we might not be as successful as we have been in keeping those young people in the loop and with us.
The young people that we work with face incredible challenges on a day-to-day basis.
Flip it.
They're growing up with really very few role models, and they're really having to battle through just to survive. And actually survival is their first priority, ahead of achieving, ahead of going on and doing great things. And the temptations are absolutely massive out there. So estate culture and some of the things that come with living in an area of deprivation make it really tough for a young person.
When I was in year 11, I found out that I was an illegal immigrant, and my mum didn't tell me this till last minute because I really never got the chance to talk about it with my mum.
I have faced a lot through my life since the first one passed away. It's been so hard on me and my mum, my dad.
Well, in 2004, I lost my grandfather, who was very close to me. And that was quite a struggle for some time due to, obviously, me being so close to him. And I haven't really had my dad in my life either due to the fact that he's been inside and outside of prison.
But I suppose as I've gone along and I've matured through help from Emerge, actually, I see it as like a place where these people I can trust, people I can talk to, people who are interested in helping me.
I had a kidney transplant just over a year ago, so like I had loads of thoughts running through my mind. I didn't know what was going to happen, and if worse came to worse, what would happen? So like Emerge really helped me get through that process.
After being returned back to Bradford and Emerge fighting my case to get me out of Yarlswood and finding me a new home without my mum and everything, with my mum running away, I think it's like changed my life as a whole, because now my ambition's high because I know what I want to do. I volunteer a lot, and I just really enjoy being there as a older person. I've like been inspired by Emerge. I mean, they've been there all the time throughout all the hard times and the good times and everything, and just looking back on it, it feels like they've always been there.
All right, I have four young people that I really wanted to mention tonight. Rachel, this girl is one of the most forgiving people.
They've mainly helped me with family's problems, like when there's been arguments at home and my mum's like had trouble dealing with things, they've always given me advice, prayed for me, which has helped me a lot, and things have been getting better at home.
When I was thinking of my word for Toby, I was going to say unique, but then I thought that's a bit too obvious and too...
Emerge has an ambition to grow and develop, not only in this area, but in other areas of Bradford where there isn't any youth provision. So we're quite ambitious in what we will hope to achieve over the next few years in creating community hubs in different areas of Bradford and have a strong presence in the local schools. But in order to build something, in order to become a professional organisation who can really robustly have the systems in place and have the level of impact we desire, we need to professionalise ourselves. We need to have processes and opportunity to grow as a business, and we have to operate like that. Even though we're a charity, we have to have that business outlook. To get to where we are today, which is 20 members of staff, a building that we own, it has taken significant investment from different people. Some significant investment to note would be the investment of the social investment business, which really helped us to purchase our own building and build a hub that is fit for purpose, that works for what we do as an organisation, and allows us to invest in this community in a professional and appropriate way.
The additional capital that comes from having a strongly rooted community-based group that's highly skilled and got lots of intellectual and professional capacity inside it. So if you're looking for role models and prototypes nationally of organisations that can significantly add value working across a number of sectors, then Emerge is that.
Good goal, good goal.
We have a team who are committed to these young people to not only deliver a service with them, but to build relationship. And actually it requires them to give something of themselves to these young people so that we can have genuine and sincere relationship with them.
I feel like if Emerge wasn't there, I'd say that I wouldn't be, and I would probably be in a young offender's place or prison or something like that.
Being a part of Emerge is being the best thing of my life. It's being there for me.
If I was talking to anybody who's got money to give to Emerge, I'd say absolutely give it to them, and give it to them quick, and let's get on and to develop this model and apply it elsewhere.